We know there are many choices in internet radio, and the staff and host of LA Talk Live would like to thank you for choosing the internet's hottest destination for the most eclectic sound and invigorating talk. This is LA Talk Live. We are more than just talk.
Hey, what's up now?
Brother, what's up?
This is a group recording, man.
Lost a great one too, by the way.
Yeah,
man.
I know.
Wow.
Yeah. I thought I'd start the show off today with some Marvin Gaye, Brother, Brother. Yes, indeedy. Once again, it's the Veterans Day Live.
Hey, hey.
I'm your host, Van Eric Marshall, with
Big Dre.
Big Dre and
Kellen.
Kellen over in the house. You know what I mean? We did just lose
a great R&B legend, man.
Yeah, I mean, Bobby Womack. And I didn't even know that. I was just doing some Facebook booking and came and they showed it. So
yeah, rest in peace, Bobby Womack. That's my man, one of my favorite songs. You think you're lonely now? Wait until the night, girl.
That's right.
That was a song.
And he's been here a couple of times here at LA Talk Live.
Right.
And so that was cool that he graced us with his presence and all that. So let me see what's going on here.
Yeah, we rest in peace. We have a great show today, ladies and gentlemen.
Yes, we do.
And we want to start off by saying that about our Indiegogo campaign we're doing. For all our listeners out there, we need your support. Without your support, we need to keep ourselves on the air. So it with your contributions every day keeps us around to keep giving you this great show about the veterans. Keep the veterans well known. What you say about that, Van?
Say that one more time, because I was just being texted about Skype. I missed that.
Oh, no, I'm talking about the Indiegogo. Program.
We're
trying to make sure our listeners understand and our viewers that we out there raising this money to keep our station up and running, to all the maintenance things we're going to need. We need your contributions, so you can call in at
323-473-3100.
Not just to keep, you know, the station. It's mainly for the show itself. Veterans Day, Veterans Talk Live, Veterans Day Live, rather. It's a show that helps veterans and their families, wives, daughters, sisters, brothers, mothers, fathers, deal with the fact that, you know, somebody that's close to them served in the military. And for those military personnel, you know, getting information that let them know that the benefits is available for them, and this is how you can get your benefits.
Oh, yeah.
And this way you're not getting to run around and getting false information and departments telling you, no, we don't handle that. You have to go back where you started from.
Yep.
And that gets frustrating for
people. Yes, sir.
So who we got?
We got a guest walking in.
Oh, yeah. That's my man, George. George is in the house.
George in the house, ladies and gentlemen.
So we're going to bring him on in.
The next segment. Yes, we are.
You know what I mean? So just sit on down, George.
Have a seat, George.
Yeah, we'll get you in there. You know, wanted to keep Marvin in the background.
But that's what
the Indiegogo campaign is for and is about.
Yeah, and tell them how you can make your donations. Tell them how you get on there.
Yeah, all you got to do is just like Veterans Day Live on Facebook. And there's a link that you can go to that will allow you to go to the Indiegogo page, and then just follow the yellow brick line. The contribution button, click that.
Yes.
And then I ask you what perks you want to get, and then after that it will take you to the PayPal account, and since people seem to more identify with PayPal, take them right there. Bada bing, bada boom. Put your donation in, and we'll see what perks you want, and we'll email you and tell you to come and pick up your perk.
There you go.
I see we got Carlos in the house.
Oh yeah, he missed him last week.
Nitra,
I love Nitra.
I got it right. Did I get it right?
Oh yeah, he been practicing.
I was practicing that like all week.
It's amazing. It's amazing. Oh, you know yeah, I mean? It's definitely. It's so, how your week start off?
It's
last
pretty
week,
good,
man.
Like I said, you know, I'm taking American Sign Language.
All right.
So you know, what I mean, it's right, like right. You know, it's a whole new world for me, and yeah, I'm enjoying it. Yes, and you know, I am even going to go to a gathering that the deaf community have at certain Starbucks throughout L.A. County.
Oh, really?
And July the 2nd, they're having some type of ice cream event at a Starbucks in Burbank. And myself and a couple of my classmates, we're gonna hang on out with the deaf community and see how they roll.
Very cool.
Yeah.
So well, that's a real good thing.
Yeah, yeah.
What's happening over there? Definitely.
Yeah. So that's what my that's how plus I got a quiz tomorrow.
Uh oh. You ready for it?
I'm ready.
Flashcards. Nah. That's how you do it, man.
You know, no flashcards. You know, his quizzes and his midterms are all by sign. He signs the quiz, and then we gotta look at him. And find finger spell and all that.
Wow. Oh man!
Put you on the spot.
Yeah.
Oh, know, big time, big time.
Matter of fact, he even got us standing up in front of the class, and myself and another person, we have to communicate that way. Can't talk.
Oh man!
Can't lip sync. The words, you got to just use your hands to communicate with one another. So.
Oh really. Right.
But we're getting back in hand, another Veterans Day live show, and it's starting to grow more because, like I said, we have Anitra in the house, and she's going to be
the women movement. Look out!
The
now.
Women movement of like you
the
said,
armed
so
forces.
You know, of the armed forces. So, looking forward for what she's going to bring to the table, and the ladies that's going to participate. I even spoke to a couple of ladies at the Veterans Department at the school, and they said they would be proud to come on in. So I'll hook you up with them as well.
Yeah, pass that information on.
Pass that information on and so on and so forth. So
I'm working on a couple of campaigns I'm working on right now for us vets. Tuesday I'll be at the St. Nicholas Church in Encino on Tuesday night. It's called New Friends Homeless Center for Vets. We volunteer in our time to feed the homeless vets out there and educate them more. My boy who runs it is named Bob Gale. He's former Special Forces Army. He's a humane chef over there. He's supposed to be calling in today at like 2:40. Talk about the program they got helping the vets out. And also this new thing, you know if you guys heard of it, it's called vetsfriends.com. It's to help reconnect military people to their buddies they serve with, and men and women. So I found like 7 guys in my 75th regiment.
I need that info, man. Cause there's a couple of people that I would like to see what they're doing, man. Cause we was some rowdy dudes, man. Yeah.
It's called vetsfriends.com. It's vetsfriend.com. V-E-T-S friends, F-R-I-E-N-D-S. com.
Okay.
So you can go in there and you can become a member. It's free. Right. And then all of a sudden, you see guys from you ain't talked to or heard from in years.
I want to see Goldie Scrivens. Oh, my goodness.
Yeah,
man.
So it's pretty good.
Man. There's few people I want to see what's going on and all that. What else? It was right on the tip of my tongue what I was going to say, but it must not be important. But
everything's important, man.
Yeah, but you know, that's
in this
how
world,
it goes,
man.
But that's how it goes.
What's going on the news day about us vets? Let me tell you, I heard something on the wire.
Oh, new nominee for. Possible nominee tomorrow for the head of the VA.
Yeah,
new Bob McDonald.
Yeah, Bob McDonald.
Bob McDonald.
Yeah, former head of Procter & Gamble.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Now I'm trying to figure this out. Now when we say former head of Procter & Gamble, that mean is he a Procter & Gamble veteran or he a real military vet? Somebody need to have some kind of background before they're going to take over the VA. It shouldn't be just any person that has to have a title of VA, or CEO. Because I'm getting tired of these people getting these jobs and don't know what it means to be a vet and running these corporations. It's crazy.
It should be a vet, but it's ironic you said that because in the history, again, with the class I'm taking, the school, the very first school, college, that is, for the deaf, they elected a hearing person and they got really upset about that, you know what I mean, behind that.
Amazing.
Well, it is amazing that they would do something like that.
I guess Bob McDonald brings a lot to the table. I mean, head of Procter & Gamble, they have over 120,000 employees, so that's pretty big healthcare network to manage. But mm-hmm. you're talking about jumping from 120,000 employees to managing 8 million vets.
And yeah, it's a big difference. Yeah. If you don't, you can't talk their lingo for people who understand where I'm coming yeah. from, it's going to be very hard to say I can move jobs. But let's see what he's going to do with the jobs as part of it, helping these guys have more programs to get jobs and making us wait 9 to a year just to see a doctor. See, I got blessed. I have a lot of my friends are doctors, nerve, and I get free. Just, you know, come in, we have Medicaid up, the right kind of medication you need it, and it's free. If I don't have to wait on a vet, I got those options. Everybody don't have those options. Okay. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So hopefully this guy, hey,
we'll see.
We're praying for him.
He said to blame him. Yeah. Oh, and
he's
not
in yet, though.
Yeah.
Brother by the name of Deshaun, he was here.
Mm-hmm.
Remember him?
Oh yeah. The filmmaker. Well, yes, sir.
And author of a new book that's coming out for vets. He stopped by yesterday. Him and I, and we were talking about my contribution to his book.
Yes,
so he's going to be getting in contact with you, Dre.
Yeah, he told me. I
got
his text.
Cause and all that. And George, he might want to talk to you too, to put your input. So as far as being a vet as yourself, so that's something that So that's something that will be coming out soon. So that's something that I never thought I'd have an opportunity to do.
That'd be a blessing.
Yeah, and that's all because of this show.
Mm-hmm.
And what he pointed out was the other veterans that he talked is just their experience and their opinions about their time in the service. What this show brings is information. So within the book, along with the people, that's sitting in the studio, all this information that this show brings,
mm-hmm.
when this book comes out, will allow veterans and their siblings and their wives and so on and so forth understand what we go through.
And we come back home.
And when we come back home, and when we do come back home, this book can provide the proper information so mm-hmm. that they don't have to wait months
mm-hmm.
to get their benefits and so on and so forth. So with that said,
we'll take a commercial break and pay some bills.
Yeah, because
our next guest,
we got some
George.
George is coming in, and then then we're gonna have everybody sitting at the table.
Oh yes.
So you listen to the Van Eric. I mean, ooh man, you listen
Van
to
there you
listen
go.
To Veterans Day Live with your host Van Eric and
Big Dre. And our co-host.
Co-host coming on in, Kellen. We'll be right back.
And 2 and 2.
Hubert's Lemonade. Tasty, refreshing, sweet, and tart. Happiness in a bottle. Visit Hubert's Lemonade at hubertslemonade.com. Once again, that's hubertslemonade.com. Happiness in a bottle. Xavier Tees and Tots, groundbreaking fashion, forward street smart designs. Tees and Tots for men, women, and boys. Visit XavierUSA.com. Once again, that's XavierUSA.com.
Young Connection, your one-stop connection for all your graphic design and commercial printing needs. Young Connection is a full-service printing and media design company dedicated to providing the highest level of customer service and satisfaction. Young Connection provides swift response and rapid turnaround services for banners, brochures, business cards, letterheads, church bulletins, funeral programs, flyers, logo design, posters, and much, much more, all at an affordable price. Young Connection, the official printing company of LA Talk Live. Give them a call at 310-491-3336. That's 310-491-3336, or visit their website at www.youngconnection.com. That's www.youngconnection.com. Young Connection Printing and Media Services, proud sponsors of LA Talk Live, where it's more than just talk.
This is Shaquem Williams, and I'm with the Shock Factor here on LA Talk Live. We would like to introduce to our small businesses our new business directory for the month of June 2014. So let me explain how it works. We will set you up with 100 commercials, 3 times a day, every day, and 4 times a day on the weekends at peak hour for one whole month. And that's not all. We'll even provide you with your own professional audio commercial. For more information about joining our new business directory here at LA Talk Live, please contact Shaquem at latalklive.com. That's Shaquim at latalklive.com.
This is Brett Chapin.
And
hello, I'm Joel Ramirez.
And I'm Lolita Robinson Coppedge, and welcome to Joy in My House
on LATalkLive.com. Inspirational radio
with a touch of recovery.
A reality show where nothing is left unsaid
and no one is insignificant who says it.
Exclusively on LATalkLive.com. You can also catch us on iTunes Radio R&B or watch us on Ustream TV.
Reality radio handcrafted for your listening pleasure. This is LA Talk Live, and we are more than just talk.
Hi, this is John McClure Jr., a.k.a. Simply John, and I would like to invite you to join us on GospelRhythms.com every Sunday at 4 p.m. Pacific Standard Time, 7 p.m. Eastern Standard Time for our show, GospelRhythms.com Talk Live Radio. Join us as we celebrate Christians around the world in all genres of entertainment, as well as highlight interest stories on men and women who are making a difference and impacting their community. So don't forget to tune in to GospelRhythms.com on LA Talk Live. And we're more than just talk. Remember, it's a heaven's party here on earth. So live life. Love God.
What's up, world? This is Nicholas Cage inviting you to join us every Sunday, 7 p.m. Pacific Time for New Rules Radio. Join us as we lend our social satire to the week's leading topics, including music, fashion, and politics. So don't forget to tune in to New Rules Radio, 7 p.m. Pacific Time, exclusively on LATalkLive.com. You can also catch us on iTunes Radio, R&B, Radio Flag, TuneIn Radio, Live 365, AHA Radio, TiVo Radio, and Apple TV Radio. Or just watch and listen directly at LATalkLive.com. Reality radio handcrafted for your listening and viewing pleasure. This is LA Talk Live, and we are more than just talk.
Yes, we back. My popular demand.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, yes, and yes, indeed. Yes, sir. This is the Veterans Day Live. I'm your host, Veneric Marshall.
With and I'm Big Dre.
Big Dre. And we, as you can see, we got a few different people in the house.
Oh, yeah.
You know what I mean? We got my man George over there. George Sassai.
Right. Thank you.
Of Chai and Chat. Another family member of LA Talk Live, and then right. On his
media
right, we have Onitra.
Onitra,
hello.
And then you see, yeah, and we finally got Carlos.
Yeah, we kidnapped
Carlos.
I
finally got him.
Finally kidnapped Carlos in the house.
Yeah, we made it out here.
Yeah, I mean,
let's give him a clap. Let's give him a clap.
We'll give him a clap. Hold on, we're gonna get the audience.
Get
the audience up in here.
So how's everybody doing this week? Everybody have a great week?
Oh, it's fantastic so far.
All right.
Yeah, so we're going to start off with George, and then we're going to work our way around the table. So, George, let everybody know.
Why
you? Yeah, I don't know why. Why not
we
you?
Have to.
Why not you, as they say. But, you know, George, like I say, he has a show, Chai and Chat. Uh-huh. And he's also a veteran.
Oh, yeah.
So with that said, George, you know, tell everybody what branch of the military and your little story.
Okay, thank you, Mr. Marshall. Yes, I am a veteran. In fact, I remember that from 1960 to 62, those days, 50 years ago or more,
right?
They're trying to find somebody who is from my old country to become like a buddy, and so I won't get homesick type of thing. And they couldn't find a single Iranian, American or Iranian, in the whole army. And that made me so proud of myself that one day I said that I almost cried. Oh my gosh!
Just you, the original.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
And getting into, I got drafted. Those days where you get a letter from the president of the United States that says greetings.
And I took lunch meat.
I got that letter. And I thought, wow, I couldn't believe it. So I went to the little hamburger joint in Seattle, Washington, it was a home then.
Mm-hmm.
And I talked to the guy. I said, hey, look what I got. He looked at me and says, oh. I said, what? He said, you just got in the army, you drafted. He said, doesn't say anything in there. Yes, it says. You can read it.
You got drafted.
You are to report to Fort Lewis.
Oh, my God.
Wow.
Yeah. So, and anyway, I did, and at the beginning it was difficult. Not only just the language, but also I came here to go to school, university, and do other things. I didn't come here really to go into the army.
Right. Mm-hmm.
But after a while, I found some friends. I was, kind of alone here. I found some friends, and little by little, I started liking the place, and then I learned how to play billiard in the recreation room and all other things.
Okay.
And I today, I'm trying. In fact, for the past few years, I'm trying to encourage the second and third generation of Iranian Americans who were born here, like my kids, to kind of do your duty for your country. This country has been mm-hmm. nice to you. Pay back some.
Okay.
Give back all some, right. As I did. And this has been kind of my goal and my side job type of thing. And whenever I get on the mm-hmm. Iran and American televisions mm-hmm. and radio, whatever, I usually take the opportunity to speak about it, that hey, let's do this, and it's good. Look at me, I just got my knee replaced, and it would have cost me like 60 or 70 grand. It didn't cost me a dime. Did my cataract, and just that's just a little benefit, but it has other benefits that.
Yeah.
And anyway, this is what I've been doing, and. I'm very happy to be here because I have a feeling, I just things come kind of feeling that I'll be able to do a little more
mm-hmm.
with the group here.
Oh, yeah, definitely.
I could do something more. And since I am the, like, a gateway,
mm-hmm.
The voice, active voice of Iranian American community, I could do a little bit better by opening up that community and by letting that community know that, yes, we could do, we should do things, we could do things. And I'm happy for that.
Well, that's good, man.
That's incredible, man. But do you have any kids? Any grandkids?
Kids? Yes. Grandkids, no. No, but I have a daughter just retired from LAPD.
Oh, really?
Yes. Nice. And she went to South Dakota.
Okay.
And got herself a beautiful place, and she's rich because her husband is also a captain, was in LAPD.
Oh, okay.
So they combined, they're doing very well.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
I have another daughter, my second daughter. I have two daughters and a son.
Mm-hmm.
She is working here, and she's kind of independently
okay.
They don't need the dad's help.
Mm-hmm.
And my son is very young. He's only 26 years old. No, he'll become 27 this September. Mm-hmm. He's an attorney, brand new attorney.
Oh, really? Congratulations on that.
Yeah.
So basically, how do they feel about what you're doing, the movement you're trying to do with Iranian Americans, to really put that filter out for the younger generation to come and join the armed forces, to motivate them?
Yeah, I noticed that they are proud of that. I know that because they tell me, actually, say that really, when we see your friends who didn't care as much, or they don't want, didn't contribute, or mm-hmm. this, and we are proud of you. But they also they're highly critical of that. It's like when I wrote a book and I at the Glendale's a place, a book, large bookstore is no longer there.
Mm-hmm.
I gave a book review, and my daughter and my son were sitting there, and my daughter right after the I talked and the whole thing, and some people start buying books. I asked my daughter, "Well, how was it?" And she says that you, first of all, you don't talk very well. I mean, you still have that heavy accent, and you use the wrong word sometimes. But that's beside that. Just don't give up your day job yet, because I don't think. So, all in all, the wonderful kids. They are doing that. You know, their job.
Yeah, the American dream for them. Stuff they really want to do.
George and I, we've talked because he invited me on his show when he talked about veterans and so on and so forth, and on this show, George, I just want you to elaborate a little bit how you know. You said you had a knee replacement and your cataract, and it wasn't an easy road, you know. And so, you know, with the VA and so on. So, you know, can you let us, our audience, know just a little bit about how it affected you and how you had to, the things you had to go through just to be, you know, taken care of?
Yes. I had a knee replacement last August. And the operation was very successful, excellent. They showed me the X-ray and they explained things. That's beautiful.
Right. Mm-hmm.
But a couple of days later, while I was laying down recuperating, a young doctor came and he kind of applied a machine that would they lock your legs in there. And then they turn the machine on. The machine, while you're like this, it goes like this. And my knee, and the stitches start popping out.
Wow.
And it was excruciating pain.
Yeah.
And they took the control out of my reach.
In fact,
he told the nurses, I was surprised. And then I passed out.
Wow,
it was probably an intern.
I came on, it was I was in a pool of blood and whole thing.
Wow, man.
I never blame the whole VA or other doctors who did a good job. It's just one doctor who was negligent. Who didn't care very much. I had a problem almost all my life here, that sometime my accent, my name, my place of origin suggest to some people that perhaps I am not an American, or perhaps I don't understand things, and I invariably don't understand, and therefore they could do things differently right. for me or with me than some next person. And I had that feeling almost all the time, you know, like a couple of times right, I had right. the problem. Right. But however, this VA deal, that what happened to me, it didn't deter me from really being a proud veteran, being trying to help. In fact, I talk about it. You know, I did talk about the situation. In fact, I asked people who have any problem like mine that the VA have falsified their records, as they did mine. Yeah, they said that the day that incident happened, out of 564 pages, one page, it says computer was out that day.
That is
straight bullshit. They do what they do with the handwritten things, and it says it, but that you couldn't find that handwritten also, and as I said, my file went into the risk management disk.
Well, okay.
And those are the people who did what they changed things and then happened.
Okay.
Again, I put in a claim in there. I want to get to the bottom of it. In fact, I wrote letters to Washington. I did all kinds of things that is possible so we get to the bottom of it. Then I felt that, hey, maybe I'm not alone.
No. You're not alone. I had to do a congressional letter myself for stuff at the VA. When I had my knee surgery, they shaved off the meniscus on the right side.
Oh, yeah.
When I had that, I actually talked to the doctor because some of the people that I've known there, some of the Vietnam vets, one of them that I knew, he had a hernia. Mm-hmm. Well, the intern or the guy who was supposed to be, that it's a simple operation.
Mm-hmm.
Until you actually sew part of the intestine along with a patch that goes along with it.
Yeah.
Part of his intestines died off, so he had to. Yeah, he's not the same at all ever. He's
wow,
he's done for. He's done.
Yeah,
wow,
but
it's amazing.
Once I found out more about the stuff that they're doing there, I made sure that I talked to my doctor. I shook his hand. I told him thank you very much. If you let an intern touch me, and they fuck my shit up, I'm gonna come back and I'm gonna fucking take it out on you guys.
Yeah,
they knocked me out like that. But that's the thing. There's no. There's no repercussions from on that aspect.
Yeah.
For me personally, that's bullshit.
It is. I think it's going to take a time, you know, for someone to realize that we are important to society. You know, we serve for you have the right to become a doctor, to become a lawyer, a police officer. They don't realize that.
For them, we're guinea pigs in and we're guinea pigs out.
Exactly. You know.
Yeah. And with this new person who we spoke about. May be elected, hopefully.
Mr. Nichols from Procter & Gamble. We'll see.
We'll see what happens. But I just wanted to let our audience know that George and his experience. Now, I want to just go back a little bit more. Now, when you got that letter from the president, they told you had to report to what you said.
I believe it was
Fort Lewis.
Yeah. Yes.
So did you have to get there on your own, or did somebody come get you?
No, they didn't. Apparently, they just said that you report.
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
This time, such place, which I did. And I didn't know where it was.
He thought he was going to a family gathering, huh?
There was a neighbor there, and they knew about it. He said, well, how are you going to get there? I said, I don't know. Maybe a taxi or something. It's not a kind of distance. You get a taxi you walk or you drive.
Exactly.
They knew that I, you know, like, in fact, they were a very good family in the kind of family that they, around the Christmas, they came with a basket or whatever, because I was alone and, you know, new to this country and that kind of thing. And they were wonderful human beings. Anyway, they took me to Fort Lewis. Here, now we gave you this safe and sound, and you take care of this man, okay? Anyway, so that's happened, yeah.
Okay. So
and I took my basic training at Fort Ord.
Fort Orr.
Which is closed now.
Oh, yeah, it is. Oh, yeah.
I took my kid there. We took lots of pictures from my barracks. And this is my barracks. This here was the mess hall. Mm-hmm. And this here recreation that I spent lots of time in there.
Yeah.
And you go over the bridge was officers' club, which I didn't understand. I always went in there and ate with them, which I wasn't even supposed to. Somebody told me, "Hey, you're not supposed to be here." Okay.
I'm serving. Why not? Yeah. So how can our listeners get a hold of you?
You understand.
How can listeners get a hold of you? If any kind of vets, men and women, can get in touch with you, that's Iranian American, how can you get in touch with you? You have any groups that besides yourself, how many you think is out there that's Iranian American that's served that you know of? Iranian American?
I don't know. I don't. As I said, during the time I was there, there were none. Because an Iranian, what I was doing actually, I was translating and interpreting from English to Farsi and Farsi to English for some officers, who medical officers who would come there here to United States for a short period of intern or residency type of thing for for maybe 6 months, and they had difficulty other than good morning, good afternoon. Their English wasn't that good, and mine was much better. So I started helping them out.
Okay.
And,
oh, really? And all right.
Yeah. And today, the people who are on the same time, my hometown, they came like maybe 25 young men. None of them went into army. In fact, some of them, they haven't even tried the Chinese food yet or a Mexican food.
Wow.
For some reason, they stay within that. And that's something that I also talk about, to the point where sometimes I see they don't say, "Hey, you just mind your own," you know, that kind of thing.
Yeah, exactly. Okay. But you have any outlet like email that can get in touch with you? People can get in touch with you. And somebody out there who have served now that's, you know, Iranian American, which it is a lot of guys know that when I was in, I had a couple of cats from Iran that was special ops guys. So believe it or not. And if like they try to keep it a secret that, you know, they was their religious beliefs, and it's pretty difficult. I said, "Man, well, be who you are, man. You serving our country. You here, and you was born here, and you serving our country. So, you know, don't be ashamed what your religion is." When I was, I had a lot of buddies. I had a lot of hatreds in my people, my unit, because of that. Because I hung out with all the other Middle Eastern brothers. I didn't give a damn because I didn't care.
When I do talk about that, trying to, as I said, encourage them, for some reason I get emotionally. I mean, I get swayed away from sitting and talking kind of deliberate, slow talk. I just get quickly talk, you know, tell me why you don't want to become, you know, that kind of thing. Yeah. Why you don't, you know, and that doesn't always go well, but I learned to, little by little, to, I have two emails, and I have a... in Facebook, I write about the same thing.
And let them know what the email is. Yeah. Can tell you. Yes, what is it?
Okay, I have the one of them is called George. Dot Hassanzadeh. It's HASSANZADEH.com at the Gmail. I'm sorry, Gmail.com.
Okay.
The other one is it's about the book I'm writing, and it's called Better Islam. BETTERISLAM at yahoo.com.
Okay.
And then I have a couple of accounts, Facebook and Twitter, whatever.
No, okay. Definitely.
Right. Well, before we go any further, we have a caller on the line.
Oh.
So, caller, what's your name and where you're calling from?
My name's Bob Gale.
Hey, Bob, how you doing?
How you doing, Bob?
How you doing, Bob? Bob is a good friend of mine. A fellow special ops guy. You was referred by Chris Cassidy, Marine Corps buddy of mine.
Right? That's true.
Yes, definitely. Welcome, Bob.
Thank you very much.
So tell us a little about yourself, Bob. Can you hear me?
I can hear you now.
Yeah, tell me a little bit about yourself. What the program that you're doing out there in the Sino?
Well, what we're doing, Chris and I both volunteer in a program is called New Friends Homeless Ministry, or Homeless Center, actually. And this has been, it's been going on for a little over 2 years now. And we service homeless people, men, women, and children in the West San Fernando Valley. Now, a lot of people don't think there's homeless people out here. You know, it's kind of an affluent neighborhood. But every Tuesday and every Wednesday, we have over 100 people coming in for food and clothing at both of our locations.
Well, that's good that you do that, because you know, the homeless is all over the United States. It doesn't matter where you are, where you're at. They could be in Beverly Hills. They can be in Hollywood Hills. They can be anywhere. And the fact that you out there helping veterans, I commend you on that.
Well, thank you. And a lot of people, you know, their perception of homeless people is that they're, you know, the Skid Row people that are raggedy clothes, and that's not the case all the time. Like you mentioned, we have a lot of veterans that come out to us every Tuesday and Wednesday. Mm-hmm. Men and women who have been in, you know, from Vietnam to Desert Storm to Afghanistan to Iraq, and these are people that just, they're down on their luck. They just don't have enough money. They can't eat. They can't feed their children or their family. So, you know, they're looking for just some help to, you know, to bind them over until that, you know, something comes along. Mm-hmm. And that's what we try to do. Yeah, we try to serve them with some dignity and respect, and mm-hmm. and it's something they usually don't receive.
Yeah, I heard you. I heard you serve. And Chris bragged on you, said you was a special ops. What was your MOS?
I was in U.S. Army Special Forces. I was earned my Green Beret back in 1968, and served in Vietnam '69 and 1970, infantry, light and heavy weapons, demolitions, and medical.
Wow, you my hero. I'm 3rd Battalion, 75th Ranger Regiment. So
God bless you, brother.
Yeah, you too, man. You my hero. I'll see you on Tuesday. I'm bringing in some volunteers to help with you guys on Tuesday.
Now, and we're very excited about that. Yeah, thank you.
Now, Bob, is it a nonprofit organization that you have? How do you get funding?
This is a nonprofit 501c3 corporation. Mm-hmm. 100% of our funding comes from donations. Okay. We live off donations. It's pretty hard to get donations these days. Everybody is all the charities are fighting for every dollar out there.
Mm-hmm.
We manage to get it. You know, well, but we good. Welcome any donations, any of your listeners.
Well, how
they can
do
go
you,
to our website.
Yeah, that's going to ask you
how
they get in contact with you so they can donate.
Okay, well, our website is newfriendshomelesscenter.org.
Okay.
And our phone number is 818-887-1109.
Okay, can you say that one more time, the whole thing, so people can get that, please?
Okay. That'll be New Friends Homeless Center. NEWFRIENDS, Homeless, HOMELESS, Center, CENTER.org. And our telephone number is 818-887-1109.
And where can they drop off any donations, Your address?
You know, we take food, clothing, hygiene kits. We give out, you know, anything from toothbrushes to soap to deodorants, mm-hmm. to shaving gear to, you know, anything you can think of. We like to provide that for our friends. Clothing is a great benefit. We sleeping bags, blankets, mm-hmm. you mm-hmm. name it. We'll distribute it.
Okay. Definitely.
Good.
Okay, we're looking forward to definitely partnering up with you guys here at Veterans Day Live, me and myself, and you got 100% support behind us and our people on our panel today, our brothers and sisters on our panel who are former vets. And we commend you, man. We thank you. Definitely.
Exactly.
What you're doing.
Exactly.
Well, we're really excited about you guys coming out. You know, it's kind of great to have veterans serving veterans and other people.
Oh, yeah.
So I'm excited about that.
Yeah, me and Chris go back almost 8 years, man. Me and Chris, Cassie, great, great young man. I love him to death. And he thinks Marines are better, but I said, that's okay. You know, no one's perfect. I always tell him all the time, no one's perfect. But I know you're listening, Chris. You've been texting me, but thank you, brother, and I'll see you guys on Tuesday.
Definitely. Oh, we look forward to it.
God bless you, Paul. Any last things you want to say before you go there, Paul?
Well, I'd like to just, you know, again, thank you for taking this time to bring us on. You know, one of the unusual things, let me just add this real quick. We do a sit-down dinner. It's like restaurant. It's like going into a restaurant, a mm-hmm. five-star restaurant. You're seated. You're brought drinks. We have a mm-hmm. four-course meal. We provide entertainment. Mm-hmm. So it's not like the typical homeless ministries you see out there. We really treat these people with a lot of respect and a lot of dignity and show them love. And that's what makes us unusual. We just want them to have an experience, you know, that they can at least one or two days a week they can be treated as if they were just very important people.
That's good.
You know, we try to touch their hearts.
I'm quite sure you do, and they do appreciate that. And keep up the good work, man. And let everybody know that Veterans Day Live here at LA Talk Live
is a big supporter.
Supports what you're doing, and whatever we can do to help, let us know, and we'll see what we can do.
We really appreciate it. And God bless you, and we look forward to seeing you on Tuesday.
Oh, yes, definitely. Man, get the word out to your fellow vets, man, that we got to show supporters. We have an Indiegogo to help raise money to keep this outlet going, but we can keep serving our men and women.
Exactly. Okay?
Absolutely.
Okay.
I totally endorse what you guys are doing.
Definitely.
Right. Take care. Thank you, God bless.
All right, God bless, brothers.
Now, without further ado, you know, we're gonna go over here and talk to the lady of the house today, Onitra. No break, man. We're gonna go straight on through, man.
Straight through it.
We soldiers up in here.
Oh yeah.
We'll break. They said don't rain in the army. It rain on the army. You know, break. You talking about break?
Come on, man. I should be ashamed of myself saying that. She dropped things. She dropped things on people. She dropping things on people. She do.
She's gonna drop it like a hot.
Yeah, exactly. You know, bam.
So, you know, without further ado, Miss Onitra.
Onitra, yes.
How you doing?
Welcome.
I'm doing good. Yeah. Thank you for having me.
And I'm glad to see you. You know, you're here because she was like, I'm coming.
Oh yeah.
I'm bringing Carlos.
I'll be back. I'll be back.
Yeah, exactly.
You know what I mean? She did all Arnold Schwarzenegger. Yes, you know what I mean?
Female Schwarzenegger.
You know what I mean? I'll be back.
Yeah, exactly.
So,
I
was
going to
do Arnold.
The chopper. Exactly, you know.
Get out.
Yeah, so it's like, so how you doing? How's the week? Family?
My family's good. My sister is working this weekend. She's got her reserve duty.
Right, which is good.
Cool. Oh, yeah.
Mom should be, next time I come down, I should be able to bring my mom.
Mom's coming through.
That's who started.
All right, okay. So what's new on the women's part of you? Anything?
Nothing until July.
That's good.
Okay,
that's
good.
Which is like Tuesday.
Yeah. You know what? This month went by so fast. I just can't believe it. But, I mean, I'm just going to classes, taking school, VOA.
Very good.
Okay. Oh, yeah.
I made an appointment to talk to Jim Zenner from the VOA because he's had a lot of connection with the USC and a lot of the programs, and he kind of finds out a lot of the programs before they're out and about.
Okay.
If there's anything that comes up for female veterans, Onitra has she's going to make an appointment to go talk to him and try to get the scoop ahead of time.
So let everybody know who you are, sir. You know,
yes,
you
sir,
know,
Carlos.
This came on in there.
Sexy voice came on deep.
Yeah, and this took the spotlight off of Onitra real quick.
He must be one of them old Navy boys.
You know what I mean? That's good, though. That's good. Go ahead, man.
Name is Carlos Ramirez, but we'll go back to Onitra, and we'll come back to me later on.
Yes.
No, go ahead.
No, go ahead.
Sure? Okay.
Yes.
Carlos was introducing me this morning. I'm still trying to work out the connections with the school and talking. I know you said you talked to some of the young ladies at our school.
Yeah.
So I'm hoping to get together with Zelma and send out an email where we can all get together and talk about some of the issues at the college and hopefully was transitioning from military to civilian.
Okay.
That'd be great.
Okay. And for those who are listening and didn't check out last week, Onitra is going to be representing the segment of Veterans Day Live for the women of the military. It's going to be, the topic is going to be about the women of the military, for women, about women. No guys, no men at all, unless they feel as though that they need a man's perspective on the subject that they want to talk about. And I am very grateful, and I appreciate the fact that this young lady that I just met through Carlos, thank you, that is willing to do that. So my hat's off to you, and I know you're going to do a great job, because the women out here, y'all need this, and this is a place, this is a format that you guys can call somewhat home.
Okay. I think for me too right now, and it's just trying to figure out where to start, because I've been so kind of on my own for so long,
okay.
reaching out, and I want to be able to talk about a broad range of women issues, not just my own, you know.
Okay. So. Yeah, that's understandable. And whatever I can do, you know, to reinforce that, when you know, just give me a call, give me a holler, and you know, if you want me to tag along. To let the women know that, okay, this is what's going on. This is what this show is about, and this is the people who is involved. So come on through, and so on and so forth. So
undo it. Let's do it. All right. So I guess we take a commercial break now, and then come back to Carlos.
Then we're gonna come back to Carlos. We're gonna save the best for last, remember? And all
yes,
that.
Yes. Yes.
All right. Let me see what I'm gonna do here, because I would just
pull up Bobby Womack, man. Tribute if you can find Bobby. A tribute to Bobby, man.
All right. Well, let me do that real fast, because but in the meantime, in between time, you know, just start talking about something, man. You know.
Oh yeah, man. Definitely, man. You know. So I mean, you know, I was, you know, like I say, back to rest in peace, Bobby Womack. I'll put up in bodyguarding them on the 25th, you know, of August, for a big charity. They was honoring him, and that happened. So rest in peace, Bobby Womack.
That's right, and we'll be right back in a moment with the Veterans Day Live.
Oh yeah. Late Bobby Womack.
Yep, across 110th Street. If you ever been there, you know what I'm talking about.
Oh, yeah.
That was a hell of a movie, too.
Yeah.
Yes. Rest in peace, Bobby.
Oh, yeah. Definitely.
So, we're back.
Hello.
This is the Veterans Day Live Show. I'm your host, Veneric. Scopes Marshall.
And I'm Big Dre.
And we got George. We got Anitra. And
hey.
And last but not least, you know what I mean? We got
Carlos.
Over there.
Hey.
Carlos.
Yeah.
We got him in the house. Finally, I got him in the house. You know, it's like almost like pulling teeth with, you know, trying to get this guy up in the house. At first, I thought, you know, when I told him what I do for a living, you know, I thought you might think, man, this nigga, man. He got this, you know, Wayne's World in the basement, in the garage type thing, you know. But yeah, man, I'm glad you're here, though, man. All
I'm definitely
aside,
glad to be
man,
here.
You know what I mean?
Definitely glad you're here.
And to let people know, Carlos, when I met him, he was at LACC, along with Anitra, and he He heads the Veterans Club, I believe, if I'm correct. And, you know, he's doing some good things over there. You know, I was new, and, you know, we had some, you know, we talked about some things, and he was able to get me to understand that things are going to get better. I'll leave it like that. And things are getting better. So with that, without further ado, we all, I take it over to give it to
give
Carla.
Him applause now.
Give him applause.
That best day's applause.
Yeah, okay. Yeah. Well, I mean, give him applause. You know, my applause is a little late. You know, they out to lunch.
The best
they
applause. There you go.
Yeah, they out to lunch, man, you know.
The applause people about been eating sandwiches.
Yeah, something. Stick your fingers.
Mm-hmm. Thank you, Dan.
So let people know what you do, man, for veterans, my man. Well, first of all, let them know what branch you were in. And
I was I was in the Air Force for 8 years. 7 years, my bad. 7 years altogether. No, eight.
Damn. Drop a
it's
thing
been,
on
it's
people.
Been a, it's been a minute now.
Okay.
From 2001 to 2008. So 7 years. My math is horrible.
Yeah, seven. Give it 7-8.
7-8.
Yeah.
Give it and eight. I was doing contracting for all that time. So I did medical contracts, commodities, construction contracts, don't matter, everything.
Anything that had to do with contracts.
Anything and everything. I did it here, overseas, Iraq, everything.
Okay.
So okay.
Now I'm a student. And I never thought I was going to be a student again. I thought I was done.
Right, right.
But I work with the Veterans Resource Center, the Veterans Club, and anything that I can get involved with that has a way to empower veterans and a way to get us back involved. Because that's what we really need to do. Because we do a lot of personal isolation, and we consider it personal growth sometimes.
Okay.
But it's not. We need to get back out there.
Well, what made you all of a sudden just one day say that this is what you wanted to do? This is like a dream of yours or your destiny, as they would say.
Well, let me give you a little background. This is the way it kind of started back in originally. I'm from Nicaragua. I wasn't born here.
Okay.
Right? We came out here through political asylum way back in the day when stuff was going crazy out there.
Exactly.
I grew up here. I went to high school. I worked for a school district after high school. And then I started learning about my own background. Things that could have happened, things that happened to my family out in Nicaragua. And there was something that I just said, you got to serve. You got to give something back. Because I was working, but I didn't feel it, you know?
Understandable.
You know, so I joined the military. And from there, it just kind of, you get to know your own country and your own people. You know, I wasn't born here. And you always have that feeling that you're here, but you're not altogether in the mix.
Exactly.
But
I know the feeling.
Definitely. When I heard you talking, it kind of struck a chord. It really did. Yeah. I think we all should give something back. And we had conversations on the break.
Right.
But we'll talk about it later on. But there's a need. There's a need for all of us to get involved.
Yes.
Yeah.
Exactly.
So after I got out of the military, I had a rough transition because I thought I was perfectly okay. I was kosher keen. And then I started doing all kinds of crazy stuff. And I didn't know where it was coming from. And for a while, I just stared at a wall because it was safer doing that than being involved with people.
Okay.
And then at one point, I'm like, you know what? I am kind of, like, I didn't know anything about veterans benefits. I thought I was done. I was done.
Yeah.
And the same thing happens. Some of the best things that happened, vet helping vet, one of my buddies came out. He had gotten out of the military. He's like, are you out? Oh, hell, I'm going to go see you. He came down, looked at me. He's like, oh, hell no.
Right.
Took me over to a Purple Heart Association. We went out there. He got my paperwork in. And I didn't know what was going on until I started getting help. And I knew that, you know.
And that's the sad part, that for whatever reason, the military doesn't think that it's important to get the men and women who sacrifice our lives to be taken care of, you know. And you know, it takes another vet to say, you know, this is what's available for you. And you know, and everybody in this room here, you know, was same way. I was the same way. I didn't know, you know what I mean. You know, even the fact that I had a brother, a half brother, and a cousin who was in the military, you know. They didn't really tell me, as somebody else told me, about, you know, what I needed to do. Another vet.
Yeah, you would think that when we're getting ready to get out of the military, getting ready to separate, they would have a VA representative come and train us, and they don't. And that, I mean, for every branch, you think they would have somebody. Yep. They'll have recruiters come in from civilian jobs in the Air Force, talk to you about getting a job, but they won't. There's no one there to show you how to transition from military to civilian life.
No way. They bring you through the front door and they kick you out the back. At the back. You know what I mean? Amongst the trash and the garbage in the alley. They got that, you know. And they said, but go ahead, Carlos. Go ahead.
No, you're absolutely right. The reason it's kind of the way it is because there's not a vested interest across the board with the people that are not in the military right now. Or they're just the people that we serve, really. The people that we serve they will say, we support you. We support you. We got your back and everything. But once you're out, you're like, oh, fantastic.
Damn right.
Yeah, exactly. Yep. Exactly.
And I think it's a point of vested interest. I don't want to bring up something that's going to be controversial down the line right now.
Bring it up, brother. It's free speech.
I was on Facebook earlier today, I've been posting, you know, the Indiegogo campaign.
Oh, yeah.
So I typed in Dave Bowie. And posted on his timeline. And so I got a comment back saying, what this got to do with David Bowie? I said, well, I'm just posting on everybody's page, you know, for support for veterans. Wow. So you're telling me, and I said it like that, so you're saying that you and David Bowie don't support vets? You know, yeah, what's up?
Let me know now if I can stop buying your music then.
I mean, I'm letting everybody know from David Bowie to the Pope.
Yeah.
It doesn't matter. You know what I mean? So you're telling me you don't support vets?
Wow.
So I ain't getting no response after that.
I'm sure you didn't.
Yeah. You know,
don't want to get my little country black butt started. Cause it'd be a revolution all over the sucker. It'd be Veterans of Evil meets Halo 4. Because I'd be having people hating me. I'd be having scouts and sniper scouts on scopes on my forehead and dots. Because I'm be real with you. I know how you feel. Barely being away from home and coming to another country, like you were saying. Give back. Yeah, for anybody who comes from another country and serving our armed forces, go when you get out, go back and visit your old neighborhood and for the next generation. So look, it did good things for me. We're not saying the system's the best system in the world. We never once said that. What we're saying is make sure you understand, educate yourself before you make that decision to go in the armed forces. That's why I told my son, don't just do it because you think it's the peace and green. It's not.
Get your information first.
Oh, yeah. Get your information. Then you go and take care of country. And, I mean, I was sworn to defend it against foreign and domestic. And all this, you should, the guy in Texas, another a true American that's connected to terrorism. I'm like, really? What are you people thinking in militia groups? They do that. Then you get mad at you and call people ragheads and all that stuff. I said, well, they over here, like anybody else, trying to make an honest living. You know, but then you're going to call them out their name and they all of this, all of that. But at the same time, they here supporting, paying taxes like you are, but you over there making up bombs and you're supposed to be American. I'm a true American. Okay, you are. But you over there plotting with terrorist cells. Yeah. It's amazing.
Yeah. So also, Carlos, let people know that what you're doing now as far as with the school.
At the school? I'm at LACC. I'm the veterans... the Veterans Club president. What we're doing is trying to get as many veterans that are already in school, because there's a lot of veterans in school that nobody knows about. Yeah. When I started there, I had this revelation. Now, at the time, we had a lot of very vocal and active vets. Mm-hmm. And when I mean in class, I mean you have guys that just kind of go off.
Oh, yeah.
And what was happening, and I found this out, is that you would have the faculty start being scared of the vets. So then that would translate into, you know, bad service and bad service, and more people getting pissed off. So what I did is one of the first things that we did is we did we kind of had to brainstorm this one. How do we affect something? How do we affect any kind of change without scaring them or pissing them off again? We did a ribbon program. We all got together and started cutting up little ribbons, little baby flags. We gave it out to every single vet that we could find. And then I went to the president's office, everybody, all the faculty that I could get my hands on. And I told them, everybody that you see with a flag, under undershirt, lapels, or anything, they're vets.
Yeah, period.
And the ones that you hear and that have an issue, maybe they have something that's not diagnosed yet. Something's going on, but don't let that one tiny percentage that need the help exactly taint what you think of all the vets around you.
Bingo.
So what we've been doing is any kind of positive reinforcement, any kind of positive movement, get as many people involved that make a difference, at least in that small area.
Oh, yeah.
You know, you have to kind of do it that way.
Oh,
it's
yeah.
pick your battles. It's all about picking battles.
I'm going to tell you. I'm a huge fan of coming to that. I mean, like the late Maya Angelou said, you know, how can you trust yourself? You can't and try to trust a man who's butt naked, who offer you a shirt off his back. How are you going to trust somebody like that if he ain't got no shirt off his back to give you? Instead of you trusting yourself first, then you go out there and help others. You got to first have belief in who you are to go out and help other vets. Mm-hmm. That's why I tell these guys, these men and women, every day, you know, period.
Because I was telling them, look, we have like 630-odd veterans registered right now. And when they started seeing how many people actually had that flag on them, they started saying, wait, we got a lot of vets. I'm like, yeah, you got a lot of vets. And they're the ones that you never hear about. They do their homework. They get their straight, you know, the good grades.
Yep.
And they press on because that's what they do. That's what we do.
Yeah, exactly.
You move on. You get your stuff done and you move on. Now, where they are in their own in their own progression, I don't know. But the ones who need the help, don't just shun them. You know?
Yes, sir.
There's a lot that has to do with patience.
Yeah.
And not being afraid. And some of the stuff that we have to take on is showing them not to be afraid.
Yes, sir.
So. Exactly, and I've seen some improvement within the department with the federal building with the vote rehab bringing having I forget the lady's name, she's there like twice a week, the gentleman who's the counselor,
Gary Fujiwara,
and the gentleman who's the counselor for the veterans, he's on, you know, and he gets things done. And he helps the veterans get their ed plan together so that Zelma can get our benefits and, you know, I mean, our pay and so on and so forth. So, you know, I've seen a nice improvement from the time I went there because it was definitely a clusterfuck when I got there. You know what I mean? and I was like, wait a minute. I opted out because I was going to Long Beach City College. So I said, well, I'm going to go to LACC because it's closer. And then I said, oh, my God, what did I do the wrong thing? But, you know, I hung in there, and things are getting better. I established a nice rapport with you guys, and look at us now. We're sitting there doing our thing on a show for veterans by veterans, and we're making a difference.
No, and the war is just beginning.
Yeah, so you know.
I want to take it back real quick to what Drea said, because this is something I've been thinking about. I think as a veteran too, this is really important. Helping yourself first. You think about how when you're on an airplane, they tell you to put your mask on first before you put on a child's mask.
Period.
I know I'm in a place now where I can help out other veterans because I've taken that time to help myself first.
Exactly.
Where if I'd done this maybe a couple years ago, I wouldn't be at that point. So I think as, just like we give back to our country, I think once we heal and help ourselves first and take that time to get healthy, once we get to that point, we should take what we've got and give it to other veterans.
Exactly. And I mean, that's beautifully said.
We do. And stuff like that because how can you help somebody if you can't help yourself?
Period, man. Exactly. But I'm finna start a revolution, like I told you. I'm finna turn to the Reverend Spike Lee on this sucker. I got an idea we're gonna talk about, and I'm gonna make this known. We're gonna do our first ever man military march. George Washington, you do.
Okay.
I'm serious, men and women. Cool. Come and tell you right now, hey, Louis Farrakhan, more respect to him. When he did that revolution, he started a whole icon. Why not do it for vets?
Exactly.
Why not start that revolution for vets and say, hey, we do have a voice. Somebody got to hear it.
Well, you know, it's like past the hour three.
Oh, yeah.
And all things good come to an end. But any last remarks?
You have some shout outs. Start with you, Carlos. Go ahead, sir.
Quick one. Okay. I'm also adopting LACC through the Soldiers Project. Mm-hmm. So I'll be referring. If you guys have any questions regarding that program, let me know.
Information, please, for me.
You can contact me through the LACC site, through the Veterans Resource Center. Mm-hmm. Send any information down there, and they'll pass it on to me.
Mm-hmm.
Second, there's always stronger people out there, man. When I met Anitra, I saw it. She's quiet, but man, there's like a steel core in there.
Just boom.
I knew it, man.
I'm really quiet.
Ninja.
Ninja.
Anitra Ninja. All right. Any shout outs, family members, friends?
Shout out to all my friends. You know who you are.
Yeah,
I'm not going to break it down, but you guys know who you are.
There you go.
Exactly.
There you go. And we will be seeing you again, right there, Carla?
Yeah, absolutely. You know, definitely. I mean,
if we don't, we're going to start crying and all that stuff.
Because I also let Carla know when things are going on, and, you know, events that he's involved with and that need support and want other veterans to participate, to let us know. He can call in or he can be here to let people know, give us flyers so we can show and all that kind of stuff with dates and so on and so forth. So,
thank you.
Yeah, support, well. Definitely. Yeah. Anitra, any shout outs?
Shout out, as always, to my mom and my sister. Give a shout out to my dad. He's Army. Maybe I'll get him out here. He's in Texas. So retired 25 years.
Oh, yeah. Okay. Well, have him call.
Have him call in.
Have him call in.
Definitely.
Have him call on in. And see, I mean, we would love to have him.
Yeah, Dad, if you're listening, she said call in or else.
Yep. Dad, come on. And Mom.
Oh, yeah, Mom, you definitely going to come in.
Next week. Next week. You know what I mean?
Oh, yeah.
We challenge him. Your daughter obligated you for next week.
So don't be all scared now. We're coming in there. And George.
Yeah. I was just thinking, you know, things running in my mind.
Yeah, go ahead.
Kind of. One is that I think, in spite of some little setbacks or problems with the veterans hospitals, that mostly our problem is from veteran hospitals.
Yeah.
I think the veterans administrations, the whole as a whole, they're doing an excellent job, and I think we should not have that to shade our perceptions or our thinking to put up something in there.
A cloud,
not that we shouldn't look into or bring it out and expose the flaws and problems.
Bingo.
We should definitely do that. Yeah. But as a whole thing, I think, yes, this is how I feel that they're doing an excellent job, and we should 100% help out whatever we can. The second thing is I was driving, coming here, I was thinking that, you know, some of these celebrities, movie stars, people with big names, the name Veteran Club, Veteran, is a magical name. Today, especially, that many people like to help. I have my veteran cap on. I walk in a restaurant. I see the guys. Hey, you know, like, they shake my hand. Mm-hmm. One paid my bill, and it's true. So help me. $68.
Wow.
With two people sitting eating at one good restaurant.
What
and
restaurant
then it's all paid. I said, well, you paid.
We go to a restaurant.
Which restaurant was
we are going together.
Where are
they? With my head on, be like, yo, what's up?
That's the truth.
I was in wearing my head
Westlake. Westlake Village. I'm thinking that some of these ladies don't have very much to do at home, and, you know, they would probably love to kind of, we have to call them. We have to have somehow make them aware that, hey, you could help. And we appreciate your help because you're a big name, and your name is a magical type of thing. It brings out people, brings out, and you could help us so we can raise whatever we want to raise for the veterans, the homeless, the veterans that they are in need. And I believe that that would, in one occasion, I used it myself, and it worked quite a bit. It really surprised me. And I think we could invite them to even come in and talk, or call them on the phone and say, hey, you know.
Well, me and Van work on that stuff.
Okay. So other than that, you were asking me a question?
No, I was saying, you would need a shout out to your family and send thank you for all the listeners out there. Need a shout out before we close the show. Anything you want to say before we close the show?
Oh, okay. I just want to say to all my friends and the entire Iranian American community, Arab, bother them quite a bit in past.
Keep bothering them.
By keeps say, you know, keep pushing on and kind of pressing on these matters that we need to give back a little. Please consider it. Have your children become police officers and veteran, go to the Army or Air Force, whatever, and do that as I've done for my children. Mm-hmm.
Right.
امیدوارم همه دوستان عزیزی که صدای مرا از اینجا میشنوند با ما همکاری کنند. خدمت وتران. درود بر شما.
There you go. All right, you, Dre.
And shout out to all my family and friends and my boy TK, Chris, and Bob Gill for calling in today. We appreciate that from new friends, homeless center, and today's show, our panel here. Thank you guys very much for coming in the show today.
Thank you for having me.
And our Indiegogo campaign, we keep pushing it. We need your funds to keep us running here. Keep giving back.
Exactly.
Definitely. Oh, pleasure.
Yes, and same here. I'm a piggy bank on that. You know, support vets today, man. We need the support, and the show here needs this. It's your support. It's not free, by no means, and it's an important entity of veterans, and it supplies them with information.
Oh yeah.
Yeah. If you want to. If you need help getting things done, this show can provide those type of information. So this way, you know where to go. You can get there, no problem. So, you know, if you know like I know, you tune in to Veterans Day Live, and check us out on Facebook. We just go ahead and like Veterans Day Live, and you'll see the link that's attached to the Indiegogo campaign. Click on that.
Oh, yeah.
You know, and click contribution and compute now. It asks you what perks you got, because from $10 on down to $1,000, you know, you get certain things. And then let us know and we'll give you an email. And we'll.
Rest is history. And just like George said, closing. Those celebrities, you know who you are, Ice-T, Jim Carrey, Drew Carey, former vets, believe it or not. You got Ice-T, Army, you know, Drew Carey, Marines. Be amazed. Even B. Arthur, late B. Arthur was a Marine, an actress from Golden Girl. So there's a lot of celebrities out there, and you hear us, and you may listen. Come in, you know, help us this campaign we started right there. You know, let the world know that you do care being a former vet yourself.
Exactly.
We challenge
them.
You know what I mean?
Definitely. Indeed.
So stop playing.
Period. All right? That money.
So with that, another day for Veterans Talk Live. I'm your host, Van Eric, with my other host,
Big Dre,
and the rest of the people, man. You know, I'm gonna close out with some Jimi Hendrix and Machine Gun.
101st Airborne.
Special
baby.
Thanks to you, Mr. Marshall, for putting this together.
Oh, yeah.
Sitting back there and controlling everything, and lots of work involved.
Oh, yeah.
Thank you.
Thank you, big dog.
You're welcome, man.
And you hear me, Richard.
And we'll see you next week.
Oh, yeah.